Hello world, this is Jeremy, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use the webhook feature inside your NAS notebooks. For those who don't know what is a webhook, it's basically a tool that enables you to listen to a website, and when an action is triggered, then your notebook will receive data. We're going to use a really practical example because I'm going to set up a form inside the NAS website to show you how I can automatically send you the template I will use in this video. Let's go. So in the NAS website, I've built a web page. And this page has a form right here with the name and the email. This is the form we are going to use. And as you can see, there is a webhook option here. So what we want to do now is generate a webhook. To get started, you need to add a first cell, which is going to be a parameter cell. This cell is going to be the one that is getting the data from your website. So I'm going to set up the cell by adding a parameters cell. It's very important you respect exactly this name. The second step is going to be the creation of your webhook. Here it is. I have my URL ready and I'm going to paste it here in the send notebook. So whenever someone will add his name and email here, the webhook will be listened to and I will get data inside my notebook. The third step is to execute your webhook and get the output notebook so you can understand the format of the parameter injected. I'm going to show you exactly what it means. Okay, so I'm going to make a subscription. Here you can see that website, I've registered my subscription. But what happened in the notebook? Coming back to our notebook, we can now ask for the output. And in the second cell, in the blank cell we have left, there is all the information we need to understand the structure of the data. There is the parameters, body, and header tag. And what interested us is the name and the email. Inject the result of the output in the first cell here to build your pipeline in the step 4. In our case, what we want to get is the email address. So I'm gonna ask for the email by putting simply body and get. This will take back the email address I've registered with. Step 5, build whatever you need. In this example, I want to send an email with the notebook template to the subscriber of the web page. To do that, I'm gonna first set up a notification system. So with this formula, I will send an email to myself as the owner of the form and to the subscriber. The subject will be get NAS webhook tutorial template. The content will be, hey, email, here is the NAS notebook tutorial template. But my work is not finished because I want to share this template. So I need to share the notebook. And this can be done through a NAS.asset.add, just like this. You will be able then to copy the URL and simply paste it here. Nothing more. Once this is done, don't forget to push the template to production once again, so it will register everything here. And if you need to iterate or debug your notebook, I suggest you put in step 7 your output once again. Here, the file already exists, so you need to clear it if you want to have a new one, and play it again. Now let's test the whole process. I'm gonna subscribe again and let's see if I receive this email. Beautiful, here it is. I have my email with my subscription email and I have also the public URL of the notebook that I can download simply here on my local desktop. The whole notebook is now available for you. Enjoy. So I hope with this first example, you're now able to better understand how the NAS webhook feature works. There's a lot of other use cases you can do with it, but I let you discover a bit more the feature. The link of the webpage I've built will be right below in the description. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up and to subscribe to our channel if you want more videos. I see you in the next one.